Well, it depends if we all survive this.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, before we go out on that first platform, there's something I want to point out to you. Maybe you've noticed. Is there anything missing from that platform that concerned you?
Mm-hmm. Guardrail?
Yeah, there's no handrails or guardrails to keep you from falling off the wrong. Edge. So don't fall off the edge of the platform. You guys okay with that?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I'll do my best.
Yeah. We're not okay with that. We just don't trust you enough not to fall off the edge on your own, so we gave you some safety lanyards. Ours are black, yours are green, but they do the exact same thing. They're going to attach to the course above you like so. That way, even if you were to jump off the edge, you wouldn't go anywhere. These will catch you. I don't recommend running and jumping just to test them because that won't feel good, but at least you'll be alive. Each one of these straps can hold 5,000 pounds. We gave you two of them for a reason. We're not suggesting anything about your size. We just gave you two of them so that we can move you from place to place. All right. So when Derek and I move you, we'll always take one of these off at a time. We always only take one off at a time. That way you're always still clipped in by one. So you'll always be clipped in by at least one of these straps. You'll never have any possibility of falling off of our course. We don't even like to use that F word around here, so I'll stop saying
that. Fun? Not that one, right?
No.
Oh, okay.
You're more than welcome to hold on to these straps while you're out there if you want to use them for stability while you walk or comfort while you cry. Just don't wrap your limbs in them or anyone else's limbs in them.
Okay.
And then can you guys remind me what you're supposed to do with this part right here?
Nothing. Don't touch.
What are you supposed to do with this, Dennis or Ted?
Not touch them.
Yeah, you're not supposed to touch them. So if you've been touching them, maybe put them back. Get it out of your system. We'll handle that for you out there.
No more touching.
Great. So Derek's going to double check your gear right now, and I'll meet you guys on the first platform. All right.
Yeah, so I'm going to double check all your gear. So I know you were saying something was kind of up with your gear, but if anyone else kind of felt like something was uncomfortable, let me know.
Figured it out.
You did?
All right. I think that I kind of controlled.
Okay, yeah, just let me know if anything felt uncomfortable, though, and I'm going to be kind of double checking everything. So you can take a couple steps this way. All right, you can step right on up.
Moving.
Yeah, yeah, it kind of moves back and forth a little bit.
Don't worry, you're
flipped in.
Yeah. Shall I go?
Yeah, come
shall
on.
Shall I go?
Sorry
about that. There's nature trails that are all right, you can step right on up.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Or you can hug the tree if you want. Yeah, I won't judge you for hugging the tree. Dennis, welcome to the first one.
Hey, thanks.
Look at that.
I'm going to attach you to that loop. Before you go throwing Elena off the edge, just keep in mind you're attached to her. So you push her off, you're going.
Awesome, let's go together. Hold my hand.
No, no. You have children, no.
I know. Wow, look at that view.
Yeah.
It's amazing. There's the bridge over there.
Here's a kid.
David, welcome to the first one.
A little bit.
I'm going to attach you to the loop here. So you're tethered on. You're free to go out towards the edge and look down if you want to test your nerves out. Or you can hug the tree.
That's about as far as I want to go.
I know. So everybody made it across the first one. No one's crying. That's a great sign. Is everyone's harness still dry?
Yeah, it's not showing.
Okay. Good. That's the important part. Yeah, so you all did great on that first one. As you can see, it's a much better view at this platform. We're 100 feet off the ground now. Everything in front of you is part of the course, so we're just going to be zigzagging through the forest here. We got 5 zip lines and the bridge left to do, so a lot to look forward to. But while we're out here, because this is a canopy tour, we might start talking about the trees a little bit. If you get bored of the tree facts, you can always just tell us to shut up. I'll only tell one fact on this platform, and then I'll wait for you guys to ask questions. And I won't bore you anymore. But we can talk about the trees. We can talk about whatever else you'd like to, though. We can talk about the course, the area in general, Derek's personal life, if you want to know about that, just ask. And then lastly, we can do some challenges while we're out here. There's some challenges on some of the other platforms just to test your test your fears.
Jump ropes?
What's that?
Tight line walking?
No, none of that. Just kind of
okay, good.
Mental challenges.
Yeah. Is that the longest one?
That is the longest one right there, yeah. 440 feet long. Are there any questions about redwoods or anything?
Yeah. How old is the zip line?
How old is the zip line? It's been since 2008.
Any people fell?
Do you really want to know? We did have, unfortunately, we had to life flight one woman out who fell down some rocks in the parking lot.
Oh my god.
That'll do it.
One woman broke her ankle falling down the stairs at the end. But no, no one's ever fallen off the course.
It's only been all stuff outside of the course.
Yep.
Like you said, in the parking lot.
So I will give you one tree fact, you know, just because I feel obligated to talk about the trees. These are California coast redwoods, and they're named that because they only live on the coast of California, and I guess their wood is red. I don't know, something like that. But these trees are known for being the tallest trees in the world, which is pretty cool. The tallest redwood in the world is 380 feet tall. Which is the size of a 38-story building. But to give you some comparison, that tree we're going to is only 280 feet tall. It's 100 feet shorter than the tallest tree. That's pretty impressive. So yeah, if you ever have questions about these redwoods or anything, feel free to ask either me or David. He knows all the recent scientific studies. So yeah, but now I think we want to keep ziplining, right?
Sure, sounds good.
Yeah, stop talking. All right, so this next one is the tallest one we have. Once you're out there above the creek, you're going to be 150 feet up, and that's as bad as it's going to get, or as good as it's going to get, depending on who you are. Because this is the tallest one, the first challenge is just to look down. If you haven't looked down yet, it's awesome view. I like to look straight at this tree in front of us because it blocks the view of the ground. But then once you zip out past the tree, the view will drop out from beneath you and you'll be staring 150 feet down to the creek below. It's a cool sensation. So feel free to look all around you want. Remember, if you don't break, I'll just stop you, so it's fine. And yeah, enjoy the view. As I go across, I just want you to stare at the tree we're going to. You might notice it sway back and forth a little bit as I go off. It just started doing that about a week ago, and we're not really sure why. Our arborists haven't had the chance to come out and look at the tree yet. So keep an eye out for that, and I'll see you over there.
Yeah, every...
Can we switch where I can go first and take a picture of him coming in?
Yeah, of course.
I'm actually going to send you guys first, so I'll bring you out here for the type of thing here. That's where women usually put it, honestly. It's the best, oh, you can see him, he's tanning.
Oh, yeah. Well, and usually it's not the safest place, too.
What do you mean?
some people get breast cancer from, from the middle of the thumb.
Yeah. Well, hopefully it doesn't happen too often, because I see that happen all the time.
I'm going to say the wind is also blowing. I know that's the zip line there. That one's going to be too.
There we go.
Wow.
So like Robbie said, make sure you're looking down right as I let you go on this one, because the whole view drops out from that tree, and it's really cool. So you can go ahead and sit down.
Okay. Dripping adrenaline?
I hope that's adrenaline.
Make sure you're looking down, okay?
Oh my god!
Yeah. And there
she's
she
not
goes.
Looking.
Yeah, I know. She wasn't looking down, but oh well.
Why is she going backwards?
I was like, well, that's why we taught you all that steering stuff.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So you can correct yourself if you start turning around. And yeah, the tree obviously, I forgot to say this, the tree obviously does go back and forth, but like, it's not like Robbie said, it's not like a week ago. That's a That's a good thing that the tree is going back and forth. So you can go ahead and sit down in the harness.
So how high are the winds before you stop?
We stop when there's sustained winds of 25 miles per hour or higher. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Here you go. Make sure you're looking down.
So how are the moonlight winds?
Like the twinkle tours?
Yeah.
They're really cool. I've never been on one because for me it's a summer job. But I've heard that you can't even see down to the bottom when it's night, because it's pitch black out here pretty much, you know. Except, and we put lights all around the platform, but that's about it. So, but I think that would kind of be a cool sensation too, because it's like,
yeah,
like you're not even,
you don't know where you're going.
Yeah, you're kind of just in you're in the middle of the trees, like the ground's not even there.
It's like the roller coaster at Disneyland in the dark.
Well, I think this is like, what's it called? Adventure California? It's not,
Yeah. Yeah.
Soaring over California or something like that. What I'm talking about? Yeah. All right, you can go ahead and sit down. This is like that in real life, honestly. Right. Make sure you're looking down right as I let you go.
So what university are you going to?
Occidental College. Yeah, it's in Los Angeles.
Right.
You can come right on up here and then step all the way up to the top.
That's a little fun.
Yeah.
But you're harnessed, so.
Yeah. That didn't bother me.
You can go ahead and sit down on the harness.
A little bit longer.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. Cross your feet.
Right, don't forget to breathe.
Yeah, look down with the GoPro.
And you have to breathe.
Breathing is hard.
You got to breathe. It helps.
Yeah, she was breathing. She gave a little woo.
Yeah, so that's a good sign.
Yeah, exactly. That way we know there is at least some breathing going on.
That's good. It's good to strain.
Yeah, I did that on the roller coaster yesterday.
Yeah. What roller coaster did you go on?
Giant Dipper.
Oh, yeah, that's super
great
fun.
America.
Yeah.
All right, you can step right
it
on
up
here.
It was different than I remembered as a kid.
Yeah, how so?
Like, I thought I remembered
it's not rattly anymore.
All over the place.
It used to be rattly.
I was a larger person then, so.
Mm-hmm.
No, but I was just rattly.
All right, you can go ahead and sit down. I think it still has the rattling sound. I just don't think it rattles you as much.
All right,
you ready?
Yep.
Here you go.
Dennis, you may step down. Zip-C is clear.
Different view from up here for sure, huh? Give me your phone real quick. I want to take a picture, because if I drop it, I don't want to drop mine.
Yeah, exactly.
There is no end.
There you go.
No. Nah, yeah, I choose not to.
Alright, we're just waiting for that all clear.
Sure.
Alright, you go ahead and sit down in the harness. Yeah, you always hear a little jumble, but you can, through all of that, I can hear him say, zip's clear.
There we go.
Different languages.
You ready?
Yep.
There you go.
Let's do it.
You need to tuck your legs and get going fast.
I'm good.
Are you even having a good time?
No, it's horrible.
I love that you can't see where you're going.
I do. I love that where you disappear.
Yeah.
I video
it. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
The bark.
Yeah.
The bark protects it from fire.
There you go. You could step down.
So that's zip is why clear. They don't want people chopping into them.
Yeah, and it also protects them from bugs and
whatever.
So what are you studying at university?
I'm studying to be a chemical engineer.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nope, here she comes.
But Berkeley's the one, you've been to Berkeley before, right? It's a wonderful school. Yeah.
She's coming in hot.
I was coming in pretty hot. I was like, oh my.
You don't have to break, I got you. And you can step on it.
How was that?
Cool.
Got a bouncer. I didn't even really mean for that to be a joke, but it was kind of a joke. That's how, like, accustomed I am to making, like, bad jokes up here, you know? It's just, they just come out without my brain even trying to make them.
So what's the furthest away that somebody has come to do this?
Asia,
Europe?
Yeah, I've had people from every single continent except for Africa and Antarctica. So I've had people from Asia, like Europe, like everywhere pretty much, you know. So whenever you're ready, you can go ahead and
bring somebody from Africa.
Thank you. I'd appreciate
that.
I'm
from Africa, so.
Really?
Yes.
Where are you from?
Democratic Republic of Congo.
Okay. How long were you there?
13 years.
Oh, okay.
Oh, there you go.
That counts. There you go. You just checked off my last continent. I'm counting that, even though you said you were from Mount Hermon.
Well, you were born in Africa, weren't you, Uncle David?
Yeah.
He was born there.
Well, then there you go.
Yeah, I'm counting that as.
No.
I'm
could apply
there
for citizenship if I wanted, but I don't want to. So.
All right. So whenever you're ready, you can go ahead and step right on off.
Nicely done, Dennis.
Thank you.
Alright, there you go. You can step down. The T is clear.
Hmm? Oh, yeah, this platform's bigger.
Well, you could argue that the tree is smaller.
Yes, that's
what it is.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Get that on video.
Kind of interesting how they sandwich that with a log. Oh, that's just to keep them apart, okay? Mm-hmm. Yeah, notch them out. That's cool.
So, is there a zip line in LA?
I'm sure there is.
There's that new glass slide.
Oh yeah, on the top of the building.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, that looks really fun.
Yeah, that looked really cool. I'll try and do that. I'm sure it costs a lot to do that though. And, I know they have that somewhere else in the world as well.
Zip lines in Vegas in the
Bootleg Canyon
zip
or
lines
city
in Vegas?
Where?
Oh, in city.
There's two.
In the old
There's one in the old off
part.
Fremont,
right.
And then there's one outside of town. That's the one we did, yeah.
I've heard from other people, too, that there's apparently one that, like, goes right down the strip as well.
Right, that's the one downtown.
Oh, okay.
And old Fremont Street or something.
Okay.
We did the one off Bootleg Canyon. It's, like, 30 minutes out of Vegas.
Okay.
How many lines was that? Five? Longest one was 13-something?
Four or five, but it's lots of walking.
It's a lot of hiking.
You think you're a professional?
And the trolleys are like this long.
Dang, that's intense.
Oh yeah, they're like 30-something pounds a piece, and we had to carry them up this mountain. And
you
this old short bus ride up to the part of the mountain, huh? It was fun.
You had to. Yeah.
I got it on video.
When did you do that?
Last month.
Okay. We're just doing all the ziplining this summer.
What else can we get to?
I know there's a couple others around here. There's like one in Sonoma, I believe.
Oh, yeah.
Northern Mendocino area? Or Sonoma?
Yeah. I believe there's, I know there's one.
San Francisco,
one.
Yeah,
right? Huh?
No.
There's not one in San Francisco.
I don't believe so.
Not legally, probably.
And I believe there's also one down in SLO as well.
Oh, I see the camera now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're kind of hidden though in the trees. See, they're like.
Until the flash goes off.
Yeah, they're blended in with that red color.
Yeah.
I don't know why we do that, because it just makes it harder to see. And it's not like you really need to, like, camouflage them from animals or anything. There's no reason for that.
Oh, are there ever any animals up here?
Oh, totally. I mean, like birds and like squirrels and stuff like that. But
up in the platforms?
I mean, I've seen birds on like the platforms before. Oh,
okay. Yeah, well, the birds I can see, but I was wondering.
You can go ahead and walk on out and then be holding on to the sides, not your green lanyards. That makes it easier. Okay. And then, you can start right now. And just
should it go in front of me?
Behind you. Yeah, it makes it easier if they're just kind of out of the way. It makes it better for the picture too.
Can we go right behind her?
Yeah.
Don't make it. Ooh. That's why they were so close to all.
Yeah. It's don't forget to breathe. And look down.
Did you look down?
Did you say we can jump? Keep going.
Don't follow me so close.
Well, I want to make sure I'm in the picture with you. Mine's over my shoulder.
You guys have the phone or the camera right now?
Yeah, it's in my pocket though, but.
Do you want me to come get it from you?
Do you want?
I'm scared to
no,
take
that's
it.
All right.
That's all right. Yeah,
maybe you can take a picture on their phone and they will send it to us.
We could do that, or we also have these professional cameras.
Professional cameras? Go ahead.
Yeah, I ask them if they don't mind.
They can just text it to her. Well, we're already over here.
Ready to go? Stay here?
Yep, right there is good. Alright. Alright, ready? 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna take a couple of them. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Alright, and I'm gonna get one from over here, so why don't you guys lean over to the right side here.
Oh.
1, 2.
Oh, you should have caught that.
One more. 1, 2. Very nice. And let's do one with the professional cameras. So go ahead and look up to the left side.
Oh, I was looking down.
Top one's the camera, bottom one's the flash. Ready? 1, 2, 3. And one more. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Very nice. All right, you can come on. How was that bridge? Better than the zip line?
Oh no, I like the zip line better.
No. Yeah, you look a little more puckered up.
I like the zip line so much better.
That's why he's like, looks like you're first.
Oh yeah.
Step right on over here. And then watch, everyone watch out for both the cable and the branch, because this is a tight little spot. So try not to bump your head. And then did you want to walk off again?
Yeah, I'll go ahead and.
Okay. So we're just waiting. There it is. So whenever you're ready, just make sure that hand's light up top.
Great job. And step on up.
Oh, step on the rope.
It was pretty hot because I was cannonballing. I was cannonballing it.
Okay, there you go. You can step down.
Nice. Did you just step off or did you get
pushed? I ran off it like he did.
Yeah, that's fun running off of it.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I didn't run, I just stepped.
Yeah, I kind of stuck back and I just went.
Mm-hmm.
Took a couple steps and... You got the sun here.
Yeah, if only we had, you know, a little bit longer of a run to really get some speed up, that'd be ideal.
Hopefully I shut the right curtains.
Uh-oh,
She'll make it.
Come all the way in.
There you go. You're turned on now.
Before the new dining
hall. All right, you can go ahead and sit down on the harness.
You want to go last or you want me to go last? I'll go last.
And then make sure your head's on the right for the picture, all right?
Yeah, perfect.
It doesn't matter.
So you can come right on over here. And step all the way up to the top.
And loaded.
All right. You can go ahead and sit down. And then cross your feet. And then make sure your head's on the right for the picture, all right? There you go. You can step up to the top.
Alright, now you can step down on the bottom.
Alright, and bring that left hand there.
There we go.
On the other side.
Alright.
You ready?
Yep.
Alright, here you go.
Eddie was the only one to get kicked off the course.
Oh, nice.
You stay standing here for 1 second. I'm just going to loosen up those leg loops for you. And I also have to attach the lanyards to you, so don't go anywhere just yet. Ground is clear.
The lanyards aren't great to hold on to as you're getting up, because they can kind of go back and forth like that. So they're not great handholds. You can go ahead and sit down on the harness. And then, yeah, you want it on that orange. There you go. And cross your feet. All right, you ready? There you go. And also, I know some people saw as we were walking over, we have an archery range down there. And they actually shot an arrow into this grove of trees right over here. So if you're feeling brave, look down and try and find the arrow.
Oh, it's still in there?
Yeah, it's in there right now, so you can step on up here.
Oh, found it.
You already did?
Yeah.
All right,
are you serious?
Don't tell anyone else what color it is. You get most spots on the platform, you can't see it. Oh. So you can only see it when you're on the zip line. All right, you can go ahead and sit down on the harness. Cross your feet. And then, yeah, you can put that hand down here.
Yep.
There you go. All right, you ready?
Sure.
There you go.
Looking for the arrow, though.
Nice and easy, Dennis. And step on up there. How was that first one?
Awesome.
Did you look down?
Of course. I'm trying to find that arrow.
Of course. Right.
I can't find that arrow.
That's all right. You can step down.
That's just a...
If to be as clear. Yeah, there's no arrow. He's just
kind of... Oh,
that's
what I figured. Okay.
That's me.
I thought it's my camera.
Oh, yeah, no, it's not the camera. I got it.
Can I see?
I'm just kidding. There is an arrow. You just didn't see it.
No, I didn't see it.